Hi, my name is Diana Campbell Betancourt. I am the artistic director of the Samdani Art Foundation. It's a private foundation based in Dhaka that supports art from Bangladesh and integrates it within wider practices within South Asia. We produce the biannual Dhaka Art Summit, and we were thrilled to have exhibited Jitish Kalat's work in the last edition in 2014. And we were also thrilled to see some of the works from the Dhaka Art Summit in an entirely new context here in Kochi. We are also very happy to have supported the exhibition, and congratulations to the team for such a successful effort. So with the Samdani Art Foundation, we support artists for international residencies, we support production of their work, and we also are developing a permanent art space in Sylhet, Bangladesh, which will include not only Bangladeshi and South Asian artists, but also international artists such as Dominique Gonzalez Forster, Philippe Pereno, a lot of names that people can see abroad but not locally. And something that I think is really important about the biennial is speaking to the cosmopolitan history of India and South Asia. Today, with different customs policies and the lack of museums, it's extremely difficult logistically and financially to show art that's not from India. And I think it's very important, since people from Kerala and from India have roots elsewhere, the way that the biennial has mix the local with the international in a meaningful way. And that's something that we're also trying to do in Bangladesh, but at a much smaller scale, as our exhibition is only 4 days, and this exhibition, I believe, is 100 days. And I've been very impressed with the local response, how engaged the local public has been with the works and also with the texts, which have been beautifully translated into Malayalam, which was, I think, a really sensitive choice on behalf of Jitish. And also, you know, Kochi, the sites are wonderful, and the way that some of the artists, such as Benita Persial, or also Andrew Ananda Vogel, have used the space to address issues that are very relevant to Kochi, but are also relevant to Kochi, but can be understood by someone from outside of this context. And I also liked the mix of not only showing young, up-and-coming contemporary artists, but also re-looking at artists who are important to India historically, such as Akbar Padamsi's animated film, which is one of the first animated films from India, done in the late 60s. I thought that was definitely one of the highlights of the biennial. And I also enjoyed rediscovering works that I have loved in an American context, such as Janina Antoni's work, and seeing it installed here in Aspinwall has added a new dimension to my appreciation for that work. I think another wonderful thing about the biennial is that it creates an opportunity for art lovers to be surprised by something that an artist, an idea that an artist might have been harboring for a long time, or something that the commercial market in India could not support. Something about India is there aren't many non-commercial platforms for contemporary art, and the biennial really provides a wonderful platform for artists to explore and push their limits outside of what might fit into a gallery space. And also for a local audience to see contemporary art in a non-intimidating part of the city that's part of the daily fabric of life here. Everyone walks by Aspinwall. Also the collateral events, like these are markets and venues that people see every day, but they can learn to add art to the fabric of what they're experiencing. And I think for the next generation, these sorts of initiatives are very important.